Hi, welcome to Lisa's Stamp Studio. I'm using a Celebration stamp set today, and if you're not familiar with what Celebration is, it's Stampin' Up's largest sale of the year, and the products in the brochure are absolutely free, and that includes this one. It's called Party Pandas. This is just one of the images that are in there, and I'm excited to show you how I put the card together. Remember, if you're here from YouTube, you'll be able to find the cutting dimensions and photographs for today's project over on my blog. I've put the link in the description bar below, making it easy for you to navigate and find. Let's head over to the stamp table and let's get started on today's project. I think she's absolutely adorable, isn't she? All right, let me show you how I put the card together. I've got a piece of Whisper White cardstock. Again, you're gonna find the measurements over on my blog. I like a bone folder for those nice crisp edges on my card. Then I've also cut another piece of cardstock. This is just slightly smaller than the card front, just for layering, and this is where I'm going to do my stamping. And I'm using my basic black archival ink. In addition to that cute panda, I've decided to use a little swirled line. This little roped line comes from the stamp set called Color Me Happy. Love it. And this, I guess, would be intended probably for the birds, but I decided I'm going to use it for the lanterns as well on this card. So I'm going to go ahead and ink that up. I'm going to make sure that the ends of the line are going to actually come off the edge of the cardstock. I want to make sure that it goes all the way across. And then I'm going to connect these. From that same stamp set, you'll see that there's a couple lanterns in here, and I thought those worked really well with the panda. So I'm gonna start with the round one, and I'm gonna stamp that one here. I'm gonna add another one here off to the side. I'm switching it up, and I'm using the rectangle lantern as well. I'm gonna stamp that here, and then another one here at the top. I'm gonna set that aside for a quick second, and I've got a piece of scrap Whisper White cardstock. And this is where I have pulled out my panda. Isn't this adorable? This stamp set is actually free during Stampin' Up's largest sale of the year. And those items are going to be able to be found in the Celebration catalog. Now, if you don't already have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator and you don't have the current annual or the occasions catalog, I would be happy to send you complimentary copies. Just leave me a comment. I'll include one of these as well. For every $50 in product that you purchase before shipping and tax, you can choose any of the products in this brochure for free. If you spend $100, there's actually another exclusive product here in the back of the catalog with a $100 purchase. But keep in mind, a $100 purchase can also yield you two at the $50 level. Lots of great things in here. Celebration runs through March 31st. So I've mounted my little panda with the party hat, and we're just going to eliminate that hat. So I'm going to actually ink him up. The basic black archival ink pad is linen based, so I like to give these solid images a little bit of a twist to make sure that I've got good coverage on him. So lots of firm, even pressure to make sure I get those solid areas out. Set that aside for a couple seconds to dry. The one thing about the archival ink is you're going to find that it's a little bit slower to dry than the other ink pads, and that's because of the archival quality. Now, I wanted to have a theme that fit what I was trying to accomplish, so I took another stamp, and this one is Here For You. Lots of fun, witty images in here, and I took out the greeting, Hang In There, and I'm going to stamp that here near the top. I'm going to set that aside and let that dry. And while it's drying, I'm going to pull out the Real Red Sheer Ribbon. This was in the holiday catalog, and it was actually carried over. So I'm going to make a small bow with this ribbon. I absolutely love that we have a Real Red ribbon now, especially with Valentine's Day coming up. So I'm going to go ahead and make myself a small bow. If you find that your loops are uneven, just like I have here, here's a tip for you. Put your fingers on the knot in the center, and then you can adjust the loops without losing your tension. So I'm going to go ahead and take my paper snips and give that a haircut here and another on this side. So I've got my panda. Now we're going to fussy cut. There are no framelits for him, so I'm just going to leave a little bit of white around him. I never want to cut right on the stamped line because I find that that just distorts the image. And remember, we're not going to need the hat. So we're actually going to cut the hat right off. So I'm going to come right across that line and take that hat right off. I am going to flip that little panda over. grabbing my dimensionals, and I'm going to put a couple on the back here and here, just being careful to make sure that they don't hang over the edges, and take off that paper backing. And then I'm going to take her, and I'm calling her a her because we're going to give her a bow, and I'm going to tip her so that she's going to be hanging right on that line. And then this is where we're going to cover up that spot on her head. Well, I gave her a big bow, didn't I? So let's adjust that again. I'm going to make that a little bit smaller so it's a little bit more proportionate to her head. All right, that's better. And then I'll trim the ends when it's on. I've got a glue dot, so I've got one exposed here, and I'm going to take the bow, and I'm going to press it right on top of there. And then I'm going to just pick it off, and that's going to bring the glue dot with it. Okay, any glue dot that's exposed, all you have to do is just kind of tuck it up on the back. And then I'm going to position that so that's not going to be very noticeable at all. We're going to do that. And then I'm going to pick this up, and I'm going to give this a little bit of a haircut. Down here at the bottom, I want to color those in. I want to give them a little bit color. So I'm going to alternate. I'm using the Real Red marker. The Stampin' Up! Markers are dual-sided. One side is the brush and one side is the pen. So I'm going to go ahead and use the brush. And I'm an outliner, so I like to outline first, and then I like to color in. Now I'm switching up to the Crushed Curry marker, and I'm going to do the same things. Now keep in mind, you can use the Stampin' Blends for this. Okay, I'll flip this over, and I am going to add dimensionals to the back. So I'm going to do one in each of the four corners. And just to make sure that it does well during mailing, I'm going to put a couple in the center to balance that out. And I'll take off those paper backings as well. And then this is going to get mounted on the base of our card. I'm just going to leave a border all the way around. Look at that. Isn't she cute? All right, here's the one we created together. Here's the one I created before you joined me. You can see, too, with the lines are slightly different, just giving you a little bit of an angle so you can maneuver this up and down as you'd like. Thanks so much for joining me today, everyone. I look forward to seeing you next time. Have a great day.